for gathering here in front of Honolulu. I wanted to share with you the results of 14 days of contact tracing here in the, excuse me, surge testing here in the city and county of Honolulu. You know, about 3 weeks ago, got a call from the White House and said, we noticed that we see a real spiking of cases on the island of Oahu. The rate of positivity is going up dramatically. You were one of the showcases in the nation. And how can we help you bring down that number? And we made several requests, but one of them was to help us with testing. As you know, the city and county of Honolulu supported testing from the very beginning of March until today. And we were told that the Surgeon General of the United States would be reaching out to us about surge testing and a program they had, which the next week they did, and by the end of the week, they brought a program out here to do surge testing on the island of Oahu. 60,000 tests done in a 14-day period. And so I wanted to report today on the last day, on the 14th day of surge testing, we have now tested 60,274 people, and we're still counting. The day is not yet over. As of Sunday, as of yesterday, there are 266 positives out of 44,751 cases or tests. 266 positives out of 44,751. On the 7-day average for surge testing, according to Department of Health, that positivity rate is 0.6, a little more than 0.5%, which is really, really good in terms of the surveillance testing that we did on this island. As you know, surveillance testing is come one, come all, we'll test everybody, whether you have symptoms or not, whether you came into close contact with someone who tested positive. We just want to know where that virus is. And we know that the spread, while it is in different parts of our community, is not spread evenly throughout our entire community. So far, 92,000 tests have been provided to the city and county of Honolulu. As I just stated, a little over 60,000 tests have been done. So the remaining tests remain on island. And we reached out to the Department of Health and Human Services in Washington, D.C. to make the request of whether we could keep the remaining tests, almost 30,000 of them, to continue to do testing. And the good news is that we received a letter today that said you will have those tests free of charge, no cost to the city and county of Honolulu, through the end of November 2020. Finally, the Surgeon General has said no other jurisdiction in the United States of America has been able to do what Honolulu has done. You know, the goal was about 5,000 tests a day. No city in this country has hit that. We've hit it and exceeded it on a number of days. But it's not just the goal itself, it's getting folks tested in a surveillance way to know where the virus is and where the virus isn't. The other thing I'm hoping it does is it allows folks to begin to think about when there's a vaccine, how we get people vaccinated in a significant number so that we can open up again without any conditions whatsoever. And that will come from a vaccine that's going to have to be distributed to many people on Oahu, and what we learned from surge testing can be applied to the vaccination program down the road. With that, I'm open up to any other questions you may have.
So good now.
So as you know, we have a second two-week stay-at-home, work-at-home order that expires on the 23rd, on the 24th. Well, before then, we're hoping by the end of this week, we'll be announcing a new order that will open up things, and retail would be one of the first things to open.
Okay, Jürgen Steinmetz. I'm just wondering, I heard from Governor Ige this morning on a TV show. He said that that there's most likely an extension for the quarantine requirements for visitors. How do you see this? Is this going to happen, and how long is it going to happen for?
So we have three times a week we meet with the governor and all the mayors, every Monday, Wednesday, Friday at 11:15, and he talked about the pre-travel test program. Just speaking for Oahu, I told them that I would support a pre-travel test program earlier than later. And the reason is right now people are coming in to Oahu, sometimes in the thousands a day, with no test, all agreeing to quarantine. But there's no guarantee they are quarantined, and it becomes increasingly hard to enforce against quarantine breakers because of all the other things being placed on the Oahu Police Department. They've been doing an incredible job making sure that people comply with all the orders that we've issued, both at the city level and the state level. And to put this additional burden is just almost impossible to meet. A pre-travel test program, knowing more people are tested and proven to be shown negative, protects all of us. And it's a program I would like to see started sooner than later.
Thank you.
Okay.
Mayor, from Gina Mangieri, KHON. She wants to know the status of the city contact tracing unit. How many are hired? What is the target headcount? And on what date does stand-up/training begin?
So, as you know, we've been pushing very hard at contact tracing for a very long period of time. And we're down, as I stand here today, hopefully by the end of the day, we'll have an agreement approved by the state of Hawaii to hire contact tracers. So the memorandum of understanding, it came down to technical legal details and that I think have been worked out. When this agreement is signed, we'll be able to hire 80 contact tracers almost immediately. Now, those tracers are not folks out in our community where we go, where they've been trained. We're working with our market research companies in Hawaii. Those are folks who, you know, make calls. They call all of us from time to time asking about products and different types of questions. Many of them are not very busy right now, but they have an army that's trained, an army that knows how to make calls, an army that knows how to report the information they gather from the calls, and they have the infrastructure to do so. And so we would be looking to hire 80 folks immediately as a first step, and then this model would be repeated with other market research firms. And our goal is to get up to 250 minimal contact tracers being provided by the city and county of Honolulu to the state of Hawaii. We are paying for the Army, but the Army is serving and working under the Department of Health.
Sarah Madison, KHON, wants to know if there will be another surge testing event on Oahu in the future.
Well, as you know, we have a remaining 30,000 tests. And we'll continue to test, probably a little bit more of a strategic way, going into communities of need, going into places where there are Pacific Islanders and others where we know that the virus is more present, so we can find out where it is and then work on contact tracing and then isolating those. But there will maybe be certain times when we'll be testing large numbers of people through now to the end of November.
And if you were to do surge testing again, what would be different?
Well, one, I wouldn't start until we had the 50 federal folks to overlook what we did on a city level. As you know, we had a hiccup on the first day, but given the number of cases we've now tested, almost 60,000 as of today, it's been pretty good. So I think overall, I'd repeat what we did, but perhaps do a little even more focusing in communities of need.
We have a few reporters asking about your takeaways. What do the number of tests conducted and the number of positive cases tell you?
Well, one, it tells me that while we know there is community spread and we know that it's in certain areas in our community, it's not everywhere in our community. If that was the case, we would have seen a higher positivity rate from our surge testing, which as mayor of the city and county of Honolulu gives me hope that we can continue to manage the number of cases so we never, ever, ever again have to do another lockdown, that instead we can take a more strategic approach in reopening and then managing the cases as we stay open.
And it looks like we only made it to about half of our goal of using the 90,000 tests. Are you disappointed in that at all?
Well, I think we've used about 60,000 of our tests, actually. And the goal initially was we were getting just 60. But when the federal government saw that we were doing a really good job of going through these tests and we could show them that our public was stepping up willingly to be tested, which I think says something for the folks of Oahu, that we are saying we're concerned, we want to protect ourselves and our family, our ohana. They stepped forward and got tested. And so we did all 60, but we asked for another 30 because we knew we could use them all. So actually we've hit the goal set by the federal government and now we're going for a further goal.
Casey Harlow, Hawaii Public Radio. How will your plan to test in communities harder hit by the virus be different from your partnership with the community health centers?
Well, this is a good question, and you know, we're really trying to beef up our contracts with our 7 community health centers as we speak. One, initially, as you know, we're paying for them to do testing. We're paying them to do the test and paying for the test kit. But we're now modifying the contracts so they can also do contact tracing that we'll pay for. So we really want to amplify what our community health centers are doing today and give them more tools to focus on the spiking cases in certain communities, like we talked about the Pacific Islander community, the Filipino American community. These community health centers are in these communities. And I think they can do a better job of finding where the virus is, finding the folks who are positive, and then helping us isolate them, for example, in hotels where they don't spread the virus and we can remain open.
Casey also wants to know if the remaining kits can be shared with counties like the Big Island that are currently experiencing a surge.
You know, we want to look at our Kuleana beyond Oahu. Of course, we need clearance from the federal government before we share test kits. But at one point, we were talking about even going to some of the smaller islands like Molokai and Lanai, putting our truck onto a plane and then flying in and taking it around those communities. So discussions have been had. They've not been completed, but you know, everything's on the table. We want to help our other counties also.
Rick Kwan, KITV, how has the solo activity program been going? How many citations have gone out?
Now, I think this past weekend, I want to say something like 5,000 citations were issued. Many, many citations are being issued. And I want to say, for the most part, you know, I'm very grateful for what folks have been doing to comply with orders, which sometimes don't make sense. But it's all about enforcement and all about trying to manage the spread. So when I opened up the Honolulu Star Advertiser this morning and saw the picture of 3 folks lying on the beach at Ala Moana Beach Park, all spread apart, more than 6 feet, you know, I was very proud of the fact that people are trying to comply. They're getting in the sun, doing what they need, but they're protecting themselves and each other.
Kimberly Speakman, KHON, is asking how the city will be working with the DOH to coordinate contact tracing.
What we're going to be doing is, one, giving them the army that they need. But we're also working with them on making sure that the army gets properly trained. And so they're telling us how the training has to be done. We'll make sure that the proper trainers are provided. And then, you know, if there are other things that we need to do in terms of reporting of information, we'll be there. And if they demand more folks, we'll be looking to provide it for them.
This is from a few reporters. Why are some businesses like Goodwill allowed to reopen again? What defines an essential business that is allowed to open?
Well, essential businesses are providing essential products like food, those kinds of things. And as long as they're doing that, you know, they are either kept open or allowed to reopen.
Where does the city draw the line when it comes to what is an essential business and what isn't? Would Goodwill fall in that category?
You know, it's a difficult question. And this gets down to fairness. You know, I just finished an hour-long call with the Chamber of Commerce and the Business Roundtable, not all their members, but a group of their members that were invited. And we spent a lot of time talking about fairness. Just shut down those businesses where they've not practiced good protocols. It's hard to figure out where that is. And I told them that I wish you could find a system that was completely fair. But much of this is unfair. I apologize for that. But it's how do we make sure the virus is managed and not spread? And some of what you're talking about right now gets down to that fairness. It's not all equal as much as we'd like it to be.
Back to surge testing for a bit. Brittany at Civil Beat wants to know how this new information informs the strategy going forward for testing and contact tracing.
Well, I think it tells us that we need to really focus on the areas where we see a lot of cases. You know, if we can do a better job of managing the spread in certain communities and certain types of business sectors or institutions like OCCC, the better we can do at controlling the spread and not have to ever do large swaths of shutting down certain types of businesses.
And another one from Brittany, since the surge testing results tell us where the virus is and it isn't, where are the problem spots?
Well, for sure, as I mentioned, we're still seeing a lot of cases in the Pacific Islander community, the Filipino American community. We know that, for example, here's an example. We know that the virus is being spread in lunchrooms of businesses. And now You know, at one point we shut down all lunchrooms. And I think as we open up and allow businesses to reopen, we're going to probably require that the lunchrooms not be open so that we don't have spread where people get more lax in their protocols and sit down and talk together. That's how we're going to use this information and be more strategic in where we focus our energy.
Following the new DOH data, Gina Mangieri, KHON, also wants to know, could the city take action to allow more outdoor usage in groups of two or more as long as everyone is masked?
So it's something, Gina, we're talking about. And just last week on Thursday, we opened up parks for all activities solo. There was a discussion initially about just opening up parks for exercise. And then we decided to be more open and allow people to lie on the beach or read a book or have lunch by themselves. And I know it's extremely frustrating for everybody. But I think at this point we keep the order in place until next Wednesday. And on Thursday of next week, should we get approval of the governor, we'll be opening up our parks, trails, and beaches to gatherings, not just of two, but of five.
I'm wondering, Mayor, having lived through this now here, and we are covering the travel and tourism industry for the most part, it seemed to be impossible to reach out to HTA, to the governor, or anyone in the state to get not only updates for travel and tourism, but also some messages. We work on our rebuilding.travel forum with 117 countries. It has been easier to get to talk to the Minister of Tourism from Syria. The lady is always attending our forum than anyone in Hawaii. Sending positive messages out, not promoting the state, is highly important. You can see it from all the Caribbean destinations, from Europe, from the World Travel and Tourism Council. Why is Hawaii so closed up?
You know, I don't want to speculate. I have to say this. We were the visitor destination for our country that was probably the safest in America. With on Oahu, with a million people, almost for days, zero cases. And we were looked at by the visitor industry around the world as a place to come. Visitors want to come here because it's safe. That is not so today. We need to get back there before we know we can return to a healthy visitor industry. I do think that we all need to do a better job reaching out to our partners in the visitor industry and to the not only the partners here on Oahu, but the partners beyond our shores, and better communication is important. I think we all can do a better job. I do think with the new selection of the Hawaii Tourism Authority head, Dev DeFries, that we should be seeing maybe more robust outreach coming up in the future.
Maybe it would be a good idea not to just have the phones at HTA staffed with full voicemails and to people telling you that the state is under quarantine and really respond. I think we can learn from Jamaica. We can learn from the Seychelles. These are all similar destinations. Yeah. We can learn from Mauritius. Very similar. It's locked down for many months, but they haven't abandoned this industry. And I think our industry professionals, that is every one of us, because we're indirectly or directly relying, should demand better from the state to not abandon this industry.
Good points, and I do think we have a lot to learn. We are the Aloha State. I would hope that when a phone rings at Tourism Authority, that would be picked up by someone and Aloha would be shown to folks. And that's about as much as I have to say on that. Thanks.
Kristen Concilio at the paper just wants to know if you agree with that decision to push back that October 1 date.
Well, you know, as I told the governor today, I support opening up with a pre-testing program before October 1, if possible. At the end of the day, there's many stakeholders involved. But I do think that starting a program, as long as we have the robust data input system in place, which I think is there, it needs to be tested. We need to start. Now, I think initially, there's not going to be a flood of visitors. That's why I think starting it'll start slow. We'll learn from our mistakes. Like anything, there will be mistakes. No one is perfect. And then we adjust and improve as we go along. Until we bring down the case number on Oahu, I don't know how many visitors will be coming here. And until we can do a better job of getting test turnaround, as you know, the test would be done on the continent before people come here. And